Before you build your story, you must collect your insights. You do this by taking snapshots. To take a snapshot, right-click on the visualization you're interested in and select Storytelling Snapshots. Then select Take Snapshot. A snapshot is a graphical representation of the state, including type and data, of a data object at a certain point in time. You can use snapshots when you build stories. When you take a snapshot, you can make an annotation. The annotation for your snapshot helps you distinguish between the different snapshots in the snapshot library when you build your story. In this example, we take a second snapshot of this bar chart after making selections. The annotation is not visible when you play the story. You can view the snapshots you've taken by selecting Storytelling Snapshots and then Snapshot Library. Here you have a list of all the snapshots related to this visualization. To delete a snapshot, select the Edit icon, then select the snapshot you want to delete, and click the Trash icon. Once you've collected all the snapshots you want to include in your story, you can create your story. Select Storytelling, and then click on Stories. Click on Create a New Story, and then add a title to your story. Optionally, add a description and select a thumbnail for your story. You can add an image from your media library or upload a new one. When you are finished, click on the story to get started building your story. Click on the Snapshot Library icon to see the list of all the available snapshots. Locate the snapshot you want to add and drag it onto the slide. Repeat the same procedure to add all the snapshots you want to use in your story. You can add different styles of text to a story slide. Select one of the text objects available. In this case, we drag a title object to the slide. Type your text, and then change the format of your text with the text formatting toolbar. You can change color, size, font style, and text alignment. Next, we are going to add a paragraph to the slide. You can also add external links to the slide. To do so, select the text, and then click the link icon and add the web address you want to link to. You can add different types of shapes on a slide. To do this, open the Shapes library and locate the shape you want to use. Then drag it onto the slide. You can customize the shape by changing its color. You can add emphasis to your insights to make them clear and engaging for your audience. You do this by adding effects to your snapshots to highlight certain data points. Click the Effect library. Locate the effect you want to use, and drag it onto the snapshot. Effects help you reduce information overload for your audience, so that they can focus on the key insights you want to present to them. If you select the Any Value effect, you can then select which values you want to highlight from the drop-down menu. Another way to emphasize an insight and reduce information overload is to hide information. For example, you could change a snapshot's appearance so that elements such as titles, axis, data point lines, footnotes, legends, and so on are hidden. To add a new slide to your story, select Add Slide. In this new slide, we're going to add an image from our media library. Then we add the title, Sales Per Region. Next, we add two snapshots from the snapshot library. Now we're going to add a paragraph to the slide. In this paragraph, we add a link to a bookmark that we have previously created for the Q4 sales. You can add live data sheets to a story slide. Select the sheet you want to include in your story. When you insert a live data sheet to a story, the current selections of the app are saved with the selected sheet. Every time a live data sheet is viewed in a story, these selections will be applied. To present your story, click the Play Story button. You can play a story as it would be presented to an audience. From a snapshot, you can navigate to the sheet and visualization it originated from. By doing this, you get access to the live data of the snapshot, where you can make new selections to take your story in new directions. There are controls for you to navigate back and forth through the slides. In a slide with a live data sheet, you can make selections just as you can in a sheet in Sheet View. You can also reset the selections you have made on the live data sheet, and you can navigate to the original sheet. And that concludes this video. Thanks for watching.